Hi all, so let's look at one of our last homeworks on 5.1, mathematical induction. And so this will be on the final, I told you, right? Although we won't have time to do a quiz on it anymore, but it will be on the final. And I will also, there's also going to be another additional review session for that. So, but this is here now looking at two of the homework problems. So number six, and they want you to prove that if you take 1 times 1 factorial, kind of silly, of course, because 1 factorial is just 1, but it is so that you see the pattern. 2 times 2 factorial, plus 3 times 3 factorial, plus 4 times 4 factorial. I'm writing a couple of times so that we really see the pattern here. Plus dot, 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 plus n times n factorial. That, they say, is the same as n plus 1 factorial minus 1. Now, be careful with this. Why do I put parentheses here? Because the factorial is something that applies to the whole of n plus 1. If I would not write parentheses, the factorial sign would only apply to the 1, which is just 1. So that's why we have extra parentheses here. So that's the statement. So this is Pn. So Pn states that this is true. And now you have to do a proof by induction. And there are, as always, 2 parts. There is the basic step. And sometimes you have to figure out yourself, what is the first step? Okay? Are we numbering the first step to be 1 or 0? Or perhaps we start even from a later step. Now, from here, it is clear that the first step is given by the first term. So that is n equals 1. So we have to do P1. So how do you verify P1? Well, let's write on left-hand side. It's sometimes good to just write each of these things. The left-hand side, what is that? The left-hand side is just 1 times 1 factorial, which of course is just 1, because 1 factorial is 1. Okay? What is the right-hand side? Right-hand side says, okay, you take... So what we do now, we plug in 1 in this whole expression. So we write it up, so it would be 1 plus 1 factorial minus 1. That is 2 factorial minus 1, but 2 factorial is just 2, because it's 1 times 2 minus 1. So this is also 1. So yes, they are the same. The induction step, and this is of course where the real stuff is happening. So what is the induction step here? Remember, in the induction step, there are 2 things. There is the thing that we assume, so assume Pn, and then to prove the next one, Pn plus 1. Always think of this as going 1 step higher on the ladder, right? The ladder, the steps are the various propositions for each of these n's, and now you're saying, okay, let's go to the next one, 1 up. But now that I know that the previous one is true, okay? That's Pn and Pn plus 1, that's what it means, right? N plus 1, the first, the former and the latter, the one before and the one afterwards. Okay, so what is Pn? Let's write it up. It's the same expression here, but I'll write it up one more time. It's 1 times 1 factorial plus 2 times 2 factorial plus, I'm not going to write everything now, n times n factorial equals n plus 1 factorial minus 1. Okay, so this is a thing that we can assume. I'm going to make it green again. What it is that we have to prove? Well, the same statement, I'm going to give myself a little bit more space here, where we replace everywhere n plus 1. So 1 times 1 factorial plus 2 times 2 factorial plus dot 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 plus n plus 1 times n plus 1 factorial. I have to write parentheses because I'm multiplying stuff, and I have to make sure that I don't misread what it is that I need to multiply. That is the left-hand side. What is the right-hand side? Well, now we replace n by n plus 1. So n plus 1 becomes n plus 2, right? So it just think of it, it's the next one, okay? So n plus 2, my parentheses went a little bit wild there. N plus 2 factorial minus 1. Of course, the minus 1 is just a 1. I don't do anything with that. So that is what I need to prove. So this is something that I don't know yet. Okay? So now comes the argument, so the proof itself, right, if you want. Well, what do? You take the left-hand side of what? of the thing that you need to prove. Not of the thing you proved, because, sometimes you do that. But often you start from the thing that you need to prove. And you try to analyze it. And especially what you try to do is see whether part of it can be written in terms of the previous one, on the previous left-hand side. And again, this is the case, right? So if we write the left-hand side here, 1 times 1 factorial plus 2 times 2 factorial plus dot, 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 dot. And so plus n plus 1 factorial. And so n plus 1 times n plus 1 factorial. So that first factorial was not there. Okay, that is... I'm writing a little bit small. I hope you can see all this. I'll enlarge it a little bit. No, then it's going to go. Okay. Now, I left a little bit of space because I want to emphasize that there is, of course, a term before that. What's the term before that? And once you realize what the term before that is, it all falls into place. Then the rest is just doing some algebra. What's the term before that? Well, the pattern is always you take a number and multiply it with the factorial of that number. And the very last one in this one was for the number n plus 1, whatever n was. If n was 17, then n plus 1 is 18. So the one before that is 17, so n. So this would be the term just before that, correct? And once you realize that, you see, but I see what is, this whole part up to here, that's nothing else than this part here. They are the same thing, okay? Well, perhaps that I should make a line like that. Let me put like a line like this. Right, so these two are the same. So, and we know that this is true. So we can use induction hypotheses. Remember, we always indicate this with this IH, induction hypotheses. That is the assumption that we made. We know that this is true. So we replace the left-hand side of this assumption by what the right-hand side says, but this expression. So we know that this is actually, I'm going to do in black, n plus 1 factorial minus 1. Now there is we replaced this green part. I still have to replace this part, right? So I should not forget that there's also there plus n plus 1 times n plus 1 factorial. And now comes a little bit of algebra that is not always obvious, but okay, let's see. And you see we need to go somehow we have to get to this n plus 2 factorial. Right? Is n plus 1 factorial, there's n plus 1, another n plus 1 factorial. Oh, when I say it, I hear it. N plus 1 factorial, another n plus 1 factorial. So these two here are like terms, where I think of n plus 1 factorial as an expression. Right? A like term means is terms where you have expressions that are the same with some coefficient in front of it. Here the coefficient would be just 1, here the coefficient would be n plus 1. But this whole thing is in kind of in a little box, the factorial box, right? 5 factorial means not 5, it's not just 5, it is 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 2 times 1, or 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 times 5, no matter the order in which you do this is not important. So I can combine the like terms. So I'll underline them, this in like term and this like term. So that is n plus 1 factorial. And how do you combine like terms? Remember, if you have 5 boxes plus 7 boxes, what you do? Well, it is, how many boxes is that? Well, 5 plus 7, okay? So we do that. Here is 1, right? So 1 plus n plus 1. Okay, so let's get rid of the boxes here. Okay. So this is equal, right? So this is equal, so I'll write the equal sign down like that. But wait, there's a little guy, don't forget this guy here in the middle, it's minus 1. Okay. N plus 1 plus 1, of course that's n plus 2. So I have n plus 2 times n plus 1 factorial minus 1. What do I want? Am I there? Not really. I need n plus 2 factorial. The factorial is in the wrong spot, you'll say. But let's now think, what is n plus 1 factorial? What is a factorial? We said it. It is, you start from 1, and then 2, and then 3, and you multiply all these numbers until you reach the end. So, what is that? When do you reach the end when you do n plus 1 factorial? When you get to n plus 1. Okay? And this whole thing, that is 1, so let me write it out here. N plus 1 factorial That is 1 times 2 times 3 times dot 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 all the way until you reach n plus 1. What was the one before that? N, but I don't need it, so I'm not going to write that up. And now this thing I have to multiply with n plus 2. Okay, so I have to multiply this with n plus 2. Now, little trick, nothing big. I'm putting the n plus 2, right? So this is now, right, sorry, I'll make my line here. So I have to now multiply this with n plus 2. Okay, so I can write n plus 2 there. But why don't I write the n plus 2 there? Because what is this now? Look, this is all the factors, multiplying all these factors, namely 1 to 2 to 3, all the way up to n plus 2. Well, that's what we call n plus 2 factorial. So this whole thing here is actually n plus 2 factorial. And now we are there because minus 1, and now we have exactly this is the right-hand side. See, we didn't even have to work out. We went from the left-hand side straight to the right-hand side, which is often the case. Sometimes you work on both sides to get somehow on the common ground. Okay, so the other one was number 16. And there, what you had to prove was also some summation formula. That so Pn is now the statement that 1 times 2 times 3 plus 2 times 3 times 4 plus dot 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 plus n times n plus 1 times n plus 2 is equal to, and here's a big huge formula, well, n, I'm going to run a little bit of space, let me move this thing here, I'm going to move this here. The formula is n times n plus 1 times n plus 2 times n plus 3 divided by 4. That seems awful, right? What is this? Okay, that's a statement, and there's a left-hand side and right-hand side, and I have to show that they're the same, and we're going to use proof by induction. Okay, let's not get scared by the complicated expression here, but just let's work our way through it. The proof by induction, the first part, and this is the part, listen, if you on the test or on the final do not do this part, I have to give you a slap on the patata, because this is so easy. This is the basic step. Just do that. Even if you cannot figure out the rest, do at least that, because then you get some partial credit for it. Not the whole point, of course, but still, at least some part. What is the basic step here? Well, the only thing that you have to think about is where do we start here, right? Okay, we start with the first term. It seems that it starts with 1, so P1. So in the case that n is 1, right, if n is 1, you should also look at what it means if n is 1. If n is 1, then this is 2 and this is 3. So that's actually the first term. So the first and the last term are the same when I do P is 1. That is means there is no dot, dot, dot. It's just this one term. Okay, P1. So we have to show P1. So what is the left-hand side? The left-hand side is 1 times 2 times 3, and I'll tell you that is equal to 6. What is the right-hand side? Oh dear, that is a big formula. That is n. Now, well, let's replace n by 1. Okay, so I'm going to do that now. So in here, I'm going to put in 1, right? That's what I do. So it's 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 divided by 4. You agree with me, right? N 1 plus 1, 1 plus 2, 1 plus 3. Okay. All the 4 cancel, and oh, lo and behold, it's also 6. Okay, great. Now comes the induction step. Induction step. So I assume that this formula up there is true, which is the long formula, so I'm just going to copy it now. Let me copy it. Okay, it's a little bit small. I'll make it a little bit bigger, but not too big that we can. Okay, so this is the thing that I'm assuming. So I'll make this green again. And what is it to prove? To show? Well, the same thing, I'll write it out now, but with one further. So 1 times 2 times 3 plus 2 times 3 times 4. You see the pattern, right? You take the number, the next one, and the next one, and multiply them. Always in groups of threes. So what will be the last one be here? Let me give myself a little bit. Yeah, okay, no, I'll write it. So what would be the last one be? Well, now we go from n to n plus 1. So this is pn plus 1. What happened to my pn? Somehow my pn, this is pn, right? So pn plus 1, that is this guy here. That is just the same as the pn, except I replace everywhere n by n plus 1. So this part, this n becomes n plus 1, this will become n plus 2, and this becomes n plus 3. N plus 1 times n plus 2 times n plus 3. And what about the question mark, right? So this one we know, we don't know this. And here we do the same, we reverse n by n plus 1. And then, of course, that becomes n plus 2, this becomes n plus 3, and the next one becomes n plus 4, right? We just add, replace n by n plus 1. Okay, so the left-hand side. So this again is, let me put it again in color, this is the thing that I still need to prove. So I start with, so the proof. I start with the left-hand side. Okay, so I'm going to write it one more time. It's 1 times 2 times 3 plus 2 times 3 times 4 plus dot, 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 dot. And I leave a bit of space because I want to. And the last term is n plus 1, n plus 2, n plus 3. And the whole thing is, again, since this is a pattern that repeats itself, right? So this is the whole thing. The only reason, when do we use induction? And when does it, what's the reasons that induction works is that the expressions are built from the previous expressions by adding one more stuff at each level, right? At each level we add something. In this case, sometimes we multiply something, sometimes we do something else. But at each level we change something. That's very often the case. And so what is the change that we made at this last level was, well, the previous level was just n times n plus 1 times n plus 2, okay? And then, okay, this plus is a little bit squeezed in here. So, plus. That is the only thing you need to see. Perhaps this is not so obvious to see immediately, but that the term just before that is this, okay? Because what you do each time, if you have, what will be the next term be? Well, you just increase each of these two numbers by one. And then multiply them. So, in other words, what's the term before this? Well, you decrease the numbers by one. So that's what you get here, right? That's the term before. So decrease this by one, decrease this by one, decrease this by one, and that's the term that just got before you. That's how you recognize the pattern that is kind of implicit in these dot dot dots. It is not very precise, these dot dot dots, but we all understand that's what the pattern is. So no question about that. But what is the point now is that this here thing now, look at this, this is the green part. So I can just take this whole thing and say, aha, this, I know what this is by the induction hypothesis. There, this is here, this is equal to that part here. So I'm going to replace that. So that is n times n plus 1 times n plus 2 times n plus 3 over 4. Plus, right, so don't forget, this is also this guy, plus n plus 1 times n plus 2 times n plus 3. Okay, so now I have to do some, normally what happens at this stage is some algebra. First of all, there's a denominator 4 on the left, and the right term doesn't have a denominator 4, so I'm going to put this on denominator 4, common denominator 4. Multiply top and bottom with 4. Okay, so if I do this, then I get, I'm going to write it one more time, n times n plus 1 times n plus 2 times n plus 3 plus 4 times n plus 1, n plus 2, n plus 3. Now, you say, okay, professor, I know what to do. I'm going to multiply everything out. True. If you do that, it will work, but look, the answer, look what we're looking for. We need something that is completely factored like this. Okay, now what do we have? Well, we have an n, an n plus 1, an n plus 2, an n plus 3. So n and n, okay, not the n for some reason is there, but oh, here it's not there, fine, that's great. The n plus 4 is missing, so some things are there, some things are missing. So can we not manipulate this? Let's keep what we have. This three guys we need. And we have them here, and we have them here. Ah, that's again the like term. principle. So I'll do it in blue. So as the previous case, right, we had these like terms here. Where was it? We had this n plus 1 factorial and n plus 1 factorial were the like terms. Okay, and that's how we combine them. So that's the same thing here. We consider all these three. Oh, that is a bit too much. All these three from here. Ale, why are you going backwards like that? All these three and all these three. All together is one like term. You say that's different, that's more than the one thing. Yeah, but that's the beauty of a like term. You can say, okay, all that I put in one too big basket. And that's my like term. And then there are two coefficients in front of them, n and 4. So, with the principle of before, you take the like term. So, let me do that first. So, you have the like term, which is the blue guy, n plus 1 times n plus 2 times n plus 3. I agree, it's not what you normally consider a like term, but it is allowed to. And what you have then is an n here and a 4 there, and a plus between them. And all this on 4. Hey, but that's what I want. Well, okay, I need to put this there, but that's the only thing. So I do get this answer. So see, sometimes some smart algebra will get you there. If you would expand all this and then combine the powers of n, the problem is you can do that, but what you then have to do is do the same with the right-hand side. Notice again, we go from left-hand side and we end up with the right-hand side here. Without working really with right-hand side. But what you could do, it would take more, but it is, if you don't see this thing, what you could do is expand all this, work this all out, expand all this in powers of n, this will be actually a degree 4 polynomial, and then this is also, if you can expand this as well. So you expand this whole thing, the right-hand side, you expand all this whole thing, and then you verify that to get the same thing. And that's enough to conclude that right-hand side is even to left-hand side. So that's a longer way to do it, but it works too. All right, that's the homework.